Hello there and welcome to Giants Live. I'm in Sacramento, shimmering in the California sunshine, and very soon 30 of the strongest men in the world are going to be here competing for the world title. Before that though, we've got one more stop to make on our Giants Live tour. It's from Glasgow and it is the World Tour Finals, a competition which last year saw Luke Stoltman snatching the title from his younger brother Tom, who is of course the reigning world's strongest man. Is this year's lineup going to be even more dramatic? Quite possibly. Let's join Radzi in Glasgow.
Hello and welcome to Glasgow for the final Giants Live of the season, which means it's the last chance saloon for every single athlete looking to qualify for the world's strongest man. And it's safe to say there are a number of characters looking to do just that, including one man who's travelled halfway around the world just to be here. He's also one of the nicest men you're ever likely to meet. I'm of course talking about Eddie Williams.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Eddie Williams.
I see strongmen as an everyday thing. It's not just for competition, not just events. It's a lifestyle. A strongman helps a lady who's left her keys in the car. A strongman helps push a car to the side of the road. So I am a support worker. I look after young kids with disabilities and on the spectrum. It's a very hard job and a unique job. You have to love the job to be able to do it. And it's very rewarding for me, creating environments for them to be able to grow, you know. It's great to be able to help the young people and give them tools to help with life. Me and my wife have a mantra: leave a room better than how I found it. It's something that I strive to do.
Yay, we're going to go.
So my family means so much to me because as a young man, I've always dreamed of having a family, you know, get married, have as many kids as I can. As a young kid growing up in Samoa, every family gathering, you know, I'd be the guy massaging all the old people's feet, you know. All the aunties and uncles, you know, it was like, hey, come here, grab the coconut oil. That gave me my heart to help people. I'm very blessed that I have a daughter with Down syndrome. The fact that I've had almost 10 years experience working with kids on the spectrum, kids with disabilities, it's almost like I had all this practice, you know, to help my daughter, to help her grow with all the battles that she has ahead of her, you know? And yeah, I just think I'm very blessed.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Dad.
We love you so much.
We love you so much. We miss you.
Good luck in your competition.
And have fun. The trophy. And be a hero.
I'd be a hero. Oh, isn't that nice, Ma?
And be a strong man.
It's almost impossible not to fall in love with the legend that is Eddie Williams, but all that friendship will be put to one side as the athletes do battle over five grueling events. And with that in mind, it's time to meet the athletes.
Not exactly. Not me and Colin. But instead, this lot. From Latvia, Eva Sportstelis, perennial dark horse at Giants Live. Then the gentle giant from Australia, and the best singer in Strongman, Eddie Williams. Well, he won the deadlift world championships in Cardiff, holds the world record for reps. It's Heinler.
It's the Andy!
Scotland's strongest man, looking to represent in front of his home fans, Andy Black. Par O'Dwyer. Sorry about that. Boyzone are missing a member tonight. Having the season of his life so far. He's been in podium contention at several Giants events this year. Paul Smith. Kordiaka, Ukrainian hero, became an instant hit with fans this year. Well, see, I don't need to say anything about him. Mark Felix. Kevin Ferris from Utah in the US. This time last year set a new world record in tonight's opening event. Lewis Jack, our second Scot, making his Giants Live debut. Mitchell Super Hooper from Canada, the man, the moose, the Maple Leaf Warrior. And this guy, very exciting prospect from Ukraine, Nakonechny. And those are your big men. Big men will be taking on this first event, the Nickel Stones. Massively cumbersome, hugely awkward. That's just you, Colin.
Oh, they weigh over a quarter of a ton together. They've got to be carried as far as possible. And Ivar Smoustelis has done the furthest distance so far, 20 meters. That's the point you hit. You have to turn around. Very tricky to come back. You're allowed to drop them once, Danny.
You certainly are. 10 seconds to pick him up again. Eddie Williams then. Dad of three.
Yes, a school teacher. Works with autistic children. And a wedding singer at the weekends, as well as an Australia's Got Talent semi-finalist. Good singer.
He's taking this slow and steady.
He's going almost too slowly, I think. There's only so long your grip can hang out. These almost like cheese wire thin grips on the nickel walking stones. Still smiling, though.
He's really be digging now into his fingers.
190 kilograms, he's a big man, he's 30 stone, carrying two very big stones.
He was born in New Zealand to Samoan parents, made his home in Australia. Now he's got 10 seconds, he thinks he can pick these up and keep it going. Very difficult though once they're down.
He's doing what's known as a hook grip. No, he's not. If you tuck your thumb under, it can help. I don't think he is. That's a bit of an amateur error. And we're not going to have much left now. That once you've dropped them once, well, he gets a couple more metres anyway.
Well, manages 16.58 metres. The crowd appreciated that.
Just an unbelievable crowd here in Glasgow. Look at it.
It was rough.
Rough. Yeah.
Just too slow. I think he was trying to go steady, so it didn't knock against the knees, because that can just take your legs out if you just overstride a little bit, but you have to go quicker than that.
Well, it's been a good year for Smith, as I mentioned. He was third going into the stones at the Royal Albert Hall, very close to a podium. There's Kevin Ferris, world record holder at this.
He's definitely the most improved strongman in Britain anyway, is Paul Smith. He's been an extraordinary surprise this year. Sure would be nice to see him get a podium and book a place to the world's strongest man. he's very unassuming. And when you see him with a lineup of guys, you think, no way can he compete with these enormous monsters. But he's tough as boots. He really is. He's a hard man.
And as well as just the awkwardness of the shape and the thinness of the handle. One of these stones is considerably heavier than the other, and balance truly is key.
Yeah, well said, yeah, it's just goofy, that's the thing. And if you overstep here, he could be in trouble. And he's just got it under control again, the swing. 20 metres, stops there. That's the sensible place to take a break.
He could be in line for a world record attempt here. Look out for the white line in front of him.
And he's got to get up, just gets it in time, and off he goes. Yeah, there's the white line. It's just only 22 metres, the world record. But this second pick, normally you get a metre max.
Look, he can see it. He can see it. He can do it.
Come on.
But by how much? How much more has he got? Wow. I thought he was going to burst into tears. Paul Smith, it's a new world record. 23.1 metres,
wow.
Nicked right in front of the former world record holder, Kevin Ferris.
Yes, and he was hook gripping there, good for him. There's a lot of pain on the thumb, but he just took it. And he got himself a record. Mitch Hooper, look at him watching on, he's impressed.
Very impressed.
Paul Smith, you've just broken the world record in the Nickel Stones. How on earth are you feeling?
I feel very good now. I didn't feel good about 2 minutes ago when I was carrying them down the track.
The crowd, how crucial were they? Because they were astronomical.
Yeah, the crowd was amazing because I've done it in training. You can't get anywhere near. It's one of those tough events where you don't know how good you're going to be because you just can't simulate that adrenaline and the rush. So once the crowd got me going, I had a little extra fight.
Mate, massive congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Four men still to go on the nickel stones, including two former holders of that world record. How will they respond? We'll find out next on the Giants Live World Tour Finals. Welcome back to Glasgow, where the massive crowd at the Ovo Hydro has already seen one new world record in the nickel stones. With four men still awaiting their turn, though, will we get another? It's back to Danny and Colin.
Well, will we indeed? It's what the crowd wants. Man, wouldn't it be nice if it was a Scot? And big Andy Black from Cumbernauld.
The big yin.
Being watched by another big in, Luke Stoltman.
Yeah, he's Luke's, of course, the former Europe's Strongest Man winner, his brother a World's Strongest Man winner, but neither man competing here today. Both are just resting at the moment. So Andy's our most senior Scot, if you like, and he's only been doing it 3 years. Already has the Scottish title, and he's actually broken the record in this and about a year's training. It's amazing, his story.
He actually, as you say, held the world record in this before Kevin Ferris took it off him in Glasgow.
Yes, and Ferris, of course, is going to go last in this event. So if Big Andy manages to do it, and he hasn't dropped it yet.
Well,
he stumbled.
We want to get past that white line.
Go on, Big Andy.
We have another world record. He's got it back.
The Biggin has it back, but how far can he take it? He's got the 10 seconds now, so he hasn't got much longer. He's just going to have to pick and go. Oh, the pain now. Go on. Nope.
Well, it all counts. 24.08 metres. That is a new world record on the nickel stones, and it's back with Black.
What a beast! Andy Black!
Well, the Scots are thrilled with that one. Black, what a monster. Just shows what a natural talent he is. He's nearly 6'8", so strong.
Mr. Pablo,
well,
neck and neck.
Another giant Ukrainian Nechanechny.
He's probably the broadest human on planet Earth.
Yeah.
I've never seen a man so wide in the shoulders. Maybe that'll help. Maybe it won't knock against his legs as much. It's sort of dangling a few inches away from them thanks to these incredibly wide shoulders. But he's moving at a decent pace, but looks a little uncomfortable. He's not used to that knocking on the knees.
Did so well at the Giants Live Open. Took that title. Just manhandling these nickel stones back to where he needs them.
There we go, he's got one pick and go now, and he is not doing a hook grip. And again, we saw Eddie Williams struggled. Both Andy Black and Paul Smith did it, and it just makes it so much harder.
Well, 15.91.
Once they start swinging about, even the biggest, most muscular legs will get taken away. And the pain.
Welcome,
horrible pain.
The Canadian, Mitchell Hooper. Crowd chanting Moose.
Well, he's just such a surprise at everything. You have no idea. He could be first, he could be last. Hard to know. He did a contest a couple of weeks ago, a warm-up for this. And he broke the stone-carrying record there. And this is a different group of men, a more world-class lineup, so hard to know whether he's going to be quite as good.
You can never discount him in almost any event.
He's certainly doing, I'd say he's doing the smallest steps of anybody, but they're fairly rapid.
He's a dainty guy. He's a dainty guy. And he's making this his own. Now we get to the turn.
That's impressive. He makes the turn, yes. All yep. he has to do is break the white line. Magnus Sven Magnussen, head referee, says yes. Now, when will he take a break? Will he go for the record in one hit? Oh! His face, look at that.
That was determination, wasn't it?
He really can dig deep, this man.
Look how close it is to the world record.
Gosh, it's no more than a couple of inches away. He's running out of time, though. He's got to get him up.
Just needs to get it across, manages it, and that is another new world record on the Nicholstones, 24.14. My goodness, now it's a Canadian who owns it.
Go Moose. Oh. You know that feeling when you've been carrying a shopping bag for just too long and you don't even want to open your fingers? Multiply that by 1,000.
Well, poor Kevin Ferris has watched it. His pride and joy, the world record for the Nicholstones, be taken away from him.
Again and again. Yes, it's now 2 metres further than he did last year, and he looked pretty at his max when he did that last year. So let's see how he gets on. He's the lightest man in the field as well. Let's remember that. These stones together weigh, well, double what he does, basically.
Again, just that frustration of how unevenly weighted they are.
The way they swing. He's doing all right, though. He seems to be handling the knocks against his knees better than anybody, because it's not the prettiest. He just seems to be able to take the hit.
I think this is a man who wants his world record back.
He's not a happy man here. He's really going for this. 4 metres to go, then. He goes down.
Goes down. 10 seconds to get it back.
I've never seen anyone do a second movement that far, though. He's got at least, I'd say, 3.5 metres, and probably 2 to 3 metres is about all you can get normally. I don't think he's going to quite have enough.
Well, pretty steady, Colin. Look at that. He's done it.
I can't believe it.
Kevin Ferris. He's just like, you're not taking my record.
What a fighter. What a fighter. Did he put that one down and take a break before it was too late? Maybe he did. Good for him. Never seen anyone carry it that far in the second effort.
That was absolutely unbelievable. You came here as the defending world record holder. 4 world records later in the one event, you managed to defend it again.
Yeah, it definitely put some pressure on me, huh? But I just went into it calm and collected. It's definitely one of those events you got to be patient on. Can't get ahead of yourself. But as soon as I picked it, it felt really good in my hands. And yeah.
It worked for you, dude, and it was a masterclass. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, what an opening event. The world record changing hands 4 times there, with Kevin Ferris eventually reclaiming it for himself. On to event 2 now with Danny.
Yes, thank you, James. And that event is the carry and drag. Self-explanatory. Carry the anchor, link it to the chain, then drag it back. Linking it together can be the hardest thing. That's where Pavlo struggled. He managed 27.78 seconds. Paul Smith, similar time, 27.3. Smork Stelis, well, he's the man to beat. Just 2/10 of a second off the record set by Novikov in Leeds. That was Europe's strongest man, wasn't it? So, Kuriaka, another Ukrainian, up against the wonderful chest play of Pa O'Dwyer. Magnussen does not approve of shifting your nipples around. This is a fast start. 115 kilos, that anchor. Very achievable for these guys.
Not so wide. Pav was in the lead there, but he goofed up. Oh, look at this! Pavlo, unbelievable. The Ukrainian, like his super wide compatriot, really quick at the drag part, and Parr looks positively slow, and they both are quicker than what Novikov did at Europe's Strongest Man. Wow.
That was very, very fast indeed. Kordiaka, 22.96 seconds.
Yeah, I mean, Parr O'Dwyer there. If it wasn't for Pav, he'd be the fastest ever.
Now, just a stalwart. The strongman world, Mark Felix, up against a relative newcomer, dancing Eddie Williams.
See, he used to be a breakdancing teacher, believe it or not, as well.
Is that right?
He's done everything. I'm not sure he did it at 190 kilos, though, and it's Felix who's got the pickup easier, but Eddie Williams, my goodness me.
Speed and power, needs to link these together now, onto the drag.
Imagine the drag would be pretty easy when he went, oh no, Mark's fluffed the linkage. And Eddie's got that 190 kilos of bulk just to pull it with. Mass pulls mass. As long as you use it right. And maybe not the quickest of leg drives, 30 seconds.
Oh no, what is Mark Felix doing?
Oh, he's done a bit of a mistake there, just grabbing the last link. You want to grab further down, get as much of the chain off the ground as possible. That friction is a killer.
Oh, Mark Felix, usually such a happy man, not a happy man now. 40.4. This was the moment he realised time was running out and he wasn't getting it on.
Well, understandably mad at himself there. Lots of mistakes.
The moves! Hooper!
Into Super Hooper. And the last pair going up against Kevin Ferris.
The man from Utah, Ferris. Once again, the world record holder in the Nickel Stones. Great start for him. But Hooper, we've seen him in loading before in Cardiff. And my goodness me, can he run with objects? Can he drag him, though? That's the next thing. He's got more body weight than Ferris. That should help.
It's speedy. Both men using the last link, though.
Yeah, especially Ferris is only grabbing the last bit. Oh, Moose was grabbing a little further down initially. It didn't bother either of them.
Oh, the carry drag and slide for Ferris there at the end.
Yeah, that's...
And look at that. Hooper sets another new world record for the carry and drag.
Extraordinary. Is there anything this man can't do?
Fit in a mini?
Mitch, two events down, that world record was very impressive.
Yeah, it was good. And I was head-to-head with probably we were probably the two fastest men in strongman, to be honest. So there's always that little bit extra in your head where you don't want to look over at the lane beside you. And it's just about not making mistakes at that stage.
Good luck for the rest of the comp, mate.
Thanks, Chad.
But at the risk of sounding like a broken record, it's another one. Mitchell Hooper this time with the new world best after narrowly missing out to Kevin Ferris in event one. And that moves the Moose up into first place overall, a single point ahead of Ferris. Meanwhile, neck and outsized neck in the race for third place, Ivar Smoke Stelis and Paul Smith. Up next, it's deadlift for reps. And with the current world record holder in this, Rano Heindler, in tonight's field, we could see this one tumble too. That's coming up on Giants Live. Welcome back to Giants Live in Glasgow, the World Tour Finals, where the world records have been tumbling. Up next, it's the Axel Deadlift. Over to Colin and Danny.
Thank you, James. And we move on to the Axel Deadlift, 350 kilos. Lift it as many times as you can in 60 seconds. It was Heindler that set the world record with 9. So far, well, Ferris, Smoke Stelis and Felix are setting the pace with 6 reps. The next pairing, from Australia, Eddie Williams, going head to head with Scotland's Lewis Jack.
Big moment for Lewis this. He's in his first ever international, having won the recent Scotland's Strongest Man contest. It comes from Govan, which is, Glasgow's just over the water from where we are right here. A lot of Lewis Jack fans in the house. And he can deadlift. He's got a strong back, and he's ahead of Eddie Williams at the moment.
These are such thick bars.
Yes, they are. They're horribly thick. Most of the guys use these wrist straps just to help attach themselves to it. Number four, are they going to give it to him? Magnus van Magnussen, he's feeling a bit tight tonight.
20 seconds left.
Made him work for that one, but Jack, now he stops there, he knows when he's beaten. One more for Williams, I doubt it, after the last one.
That is that, I think, for both men. And he knows it. So four reps for Eddie Williams, just two for Lewis Jack.
Big Eddie's deadlifts come on a long way, but there's still a lot better than him to come.
Well, on that note, this is a heavyweight bout, isn't it? Nakanechny going up against, well, the world record holder in reps, Heinle.
Yes, and also the Masters max weight record holder. He did that in Cardiff, of course. So he can pull a good deadlift, Heinle. But Nakanechny, he's a man with something to prove. He's down in eighth position after two events. That's not a good place to be for him. He was one of the big favourites for this contest. Indeed, it's Heinle who has the record on this implement.
Well, before the event, Nakanechny said he wasn't feeling too well, but he's shown no signs of that.
Well, nine reps is what it is. Let's see whether Heinle can equal his own record. Nakanechny a little bit slower, but looks like he's got a bit more in the tank. And, either of these men do
well.
Double figures.
Nakanechny onto nine now. 10.
He does it. 15 seconds. He can do 11. Heinle's not happy. He's just grabbed it and gone. He's got 9.
Well, he's already got the world record, but let's make it higher. It's 11. And it belongs to Nakanechny.
Heinle goes for one last bid. No. Stopped by the clock in the end. Well, I don't think he'd have got that one.
Well, Heinle equals his own record, but Nakanechny blew straight through it with 11.
Outrageous power from the former world champion in powerlifting. That'll please him greatly.
He's with Radzi now.
Pav, we knew your deadlift was good for one rep max, but for max reps, that was incredible, a new world record.
Yeah, I can do more, but I was sick last 2 weeks to competition. I was have temperature 39. Yeah, it's bad for me, but deadlift is my better exercise, and I can do 12, 30 reps. Yeah.
Can we talk about your physique? Because you're massive and lean. What I think everyone at home would love to see, a front double bicep. Can we see it right now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
To Mitchell.
It's like looking in the mirror sometimes. Mitchell Hooper then. Up against Kodiaka. Both men want this, but Hooper, well, he knows Ferris has 6. He really needs 7. He's going to keep the pressure on for the title, so can't afford a slip up.
Well, that was really quick on the first rep from Hooper, who's having a very good day so far. Kodiaka, it's fair to say his deadlift is not quite world class, but solid. I think 5 or 6 reps will be good for him, and Hooper, knowing him, he'll be gunning for 11.
Well, he gets the 7, and that's enough for him.
Oh, how clever. He is a bright man, no doubt, Hooper. He's gone tactics, saves him in the tank. Kordiaka still battling to get a 6. And that will put Hooper into 3rd. Is that right?
It is, but look at this with Kordiaka almost disintegrating.
Yeah, it really does take it out of you. That tight suit, the tight belt as well. Feels probably a bit faint. Mitchell Hooper, though, 7 reps. Tactically very clever. He knows Nakanechny had to go all out. A wise move.
Just keep getting 6 or 4 cuts, okay? Yeah. It helps me.
Okay.
Remarkable. At a time when many of us would be reaching for the lemon and honey, Nakanechny casually dropping another world record. Heindler in second, Hooper getting a vital extra rep over his title rival Kevin Fairies. So 3 points now, Hooper's lead at the top, while Nakanechi moves up into fourth place, 2 points behind Spark Stellis and two ahead of Paul Smith. Can the Brit respond in event four?
Well, event four is the dumbbell press. How many times can you lift it up above your head and lock out? In 60 seconds, it's 100 kilos. Well, Nakanechny, currently in third with 4 reps. Smith ahead of him in second. He managed 5. But it is Smork Stellis to beat with a brilliant 7 reps. So Pat O'Dwyer, the man who dances with nipples, up against Kordiaka.
Kordiaka very good at this event. Very skilled, very explosive. So too Pat O'Dwyer. Problem with these is they're like implements of torture. They're horrible to have on your back. They're actually just two little Atlas stones welded into a metal structure. So not exactly the most comfortable.
No, they don't look designed for pleasure. Now, O'Dwyer hasn't hit the form he showed when he won second place at Britain's Strongest Man.
Well, it's a good race, this. 7 is our leader, and Kordiaka looks like he's going to go and get that. Depends on whether there's enough time to do it, that's all. This looks so casual, Pa, the way he does it. Keeps one hand down and helps rest on his elbow. It's a really casual look.
Oh, just 5 seconds left to go. Kordiaka, does he have one left in him? He does.
One more. No.
Well, that was impressive from Kordiaka in the dying seconds. Got his 7th rep. Pat O'Dwyer with his 5.
Very explosive man, Kordiaka. Nice technique. Catches it with a straight arm. That makes it so much easier.
At risk, of course, as well. Moved him into tied first place. So Ferris ideally needs to beat Hooper by a few places to make a dent in the Canadian's lead.
Yes, very true. Hooper's really coming to form. Never count this man out. Ferris being a little bit shorter as well. Could be an advantage here. Tends to suit the shorter man. Does dumbbell.
And Ferris gets his first. Hooper's on 3.
Now, Hooper, strange technique. He's really stretching it right back behind his shoulder.
Ferris is struggling, isn't he?
Yeah. Hooper's got it right down his back. He really does put a lot of stress on his elbow. He's very good at it, and it works. Maybe a little unorthodox, but who cares if it works? He's going for number 6.
He's still got 10 or so seconds if he wants to try and tie for first.
Why not? Ferris might get a 4th as well, you know.
Well, does he lock out? Does not lock out. That was very close. Well, Ferris manages 3 reps. And Hooper so close to his 7th.
And no complaints from either man. They just didn't quite lock out. It's very close. And yeah, unless a sporting competitor might have moaned about it, but.
Hot off the press then, Smog Stellis and Kordiaka sharing the spoils in event 4. While even without that extra rep, it's still a good result for Hooper, 3rd there, with Ferris all the way down in 7th. 4 events in, the Canadians' overall lead has now stretched to 7 points, while Smog Stellis' dumbbell dramatics mean that he is now just half a point behind Ferris in 3rd, with 1 event to go. Coming up then, it is the decider here in Glasgow. As these men dream of taking that last step to the top, what better than the power stairs?
Welcome back to the World Tour Finals 2022, where the podium will probably come down to what takes place behind us here, the power stairs. In principle, it's simple. Five duck walks, all weighing from 200 kilos up to 250, and they have to be carefully lifted up those three steps. The fastest time wins, but when you consider there's a battle within a battle, second and third, Kevin and Ivers separated by just half a point, and then fourth and fifth, both Pavlos, they're separated by 1 point. So this really is anybody's guess.
Thanks, Razzy. Yep, the power stairs. First time in years the Stones haven't concluded their Giants Live. In any civilized society, this would be illegal. But the time to beat so far, Nakonechny, 38.81, managed 15 steps. So, still to come, Lewis Jack will be taking on smiling Eddie Williams. Or dancing, body-popping Eddie Williams, let's say. Now, this is over a ton of fun here. 1,125 kilos in total being lifted. I've worked it out. That's the same as 28 well-fed goats.
Yeah, that makes sense. Now then, on to the second weight. 210 kilos. And they get heavier and heavier, just like the Atlas Stones. There are similarities. You can be quick on the light ones, but have you got the power left for these massive ones at the end? Jack, slow and steady. Eddie Williams certainly attacking this well.
Time to beat is 38.81. What's Williams got in the tank? Not going to manage it.
Nakonechny is unbelievable, that 38.81. With all that deadlifting earlier as well. Oh, Eddie Williams nearly got it caught on the lip there. All the way on. There we go.
Wrestles it to the top. Got some second place so far.
Lewis Jack, can he be spurred on by the crowd here? 240, just too much for after everything he's done. He did 9. That's for Eddie Williams. All 15.
Representing Ukraine, Pablo Kuliaka.
Kuliaka next then. And this will be interesting. Kuliaka and Smolk Stelis, both very good at this event. Very fast, Smolk Stelis.
Really fast. He was the one who started a technique where you just half stand on it and keep jumping up. And it really works well, though. Sometimes you almost want to close your eyes because it looks a bit dangerous the way he really does attack it.
Just throwing them on.
He kind of leans backwards almost as well to help hoik it up.
Using his knees as well.
Anything you've got, you've got to throw at it. Ooh, and big Pav is so exposed to be staying with him.
Look at this, the time, 38.81 to beat. Smolk Stelis blitzes it. 33.02 for Smolk Stelis. Not far behind, although he's having trouble now getting it directly on. Kuliaka wasted a little time at the end there.
A lot of hard work by Kuliaka at the end there. But, if it was just the first four weights, he'd have been lightning. But that 15 steps, Max Stelis, almost as quick as the first. That's really impressive.
Please raise it up and welcome Captain Pam.
So really, it comes down to this. Ferris has to put in an epic time. Has to beat Hooper by several places to win this title. Hooper just needs to not mess it up.
Well, I hate to remind everybody, but in Cardiff, he had a similar lead. Sadly, blew it in the Atlas Stones, but that was to wide Pav, who just went wild. But can Ferris do exactly that and go wild here in the power stairs and put pressure on the Moose?
Hooper, a little quicker.
And I saw Hooper talking to Smolk Stelis, and he's copied his technique, I think.
It's the Hooper hop.
It's that half feet on and then lean backwards. It doesn't look exactly the safest technique to me, but it works. But look at this, Ferris is catching. If Hooper runs out of steam, this could be a different story, you know.
Well, it's neck and neck. Who's going to take it? Well, Ferris, just ahead of Hooper, looked delighted by it.
Don't think it's enough. Too little, too late.
Well, let's look at what happened there. And my goodness me. A very fast time from Nakonechny, 38.81, was then blitzed by Schmork Stelis, 33.02. But what does this do to the final standings? Well, Mitchell Hooper is the World Tour Finals champion. After finishing runner-up twice this year at other Giants Live events, he accepts the Dr. Douglas Edmonds Trophy. Now has to work out how to fit it into his hand luggage to take it back to Canada.
Mitch, you've just earned your first Giants Live title. In terms of arriving, it seems like this is now official. Potential is one thing, but you've realised that potential, and I think the future's looking pretty bright.
But now we have expectation, don't we?
How do you deal with that?
That's harder for me. That's harder. I prefer to be the underdog. But it's a whole new kettle of fish and a whole new challenge. And at some point in your life, you've got to go in as having expectations and something. So I'm excited to take on the challenge in terms of personal growth.
World Tour Champion 2022, Mitchell Hooper, congratulations.
Thanks, Rad. Thank you.
Well, it's been an incredible qualifying tour. So let's end with a montage.
Welcome to Sheffield and welcome to Britain's Strongest Man.
Easy, baby, easy.
From Leeds, we bring you Europe's Strongest Man.
Welcome to one of the grandest venues on planet Earth.
We are in Cardiff for a deadlift world championship.
Welcome to Glasgow for the final Giants Live of the season.
Well, there you go. That's it for Giants Live. But there's barely time to catch your breath before the big one gets underway. World's Strongest Man right here in Sacramento, California. Do hope you'll be joining us for that next time out. For now, though, from me and all the Giants, it's goodbye.
And you can see that as World's Strongest Man continues tomorrow at 7. It might be an idea to start limbering up, as we'll have you headbanging and air guitaring the night away with Britain's favourite rock songs brand new at 10. Before that, remembering a legend of British comedy, Les Dawson, 30 Funniest Moments, is next.